Good day everybody. In this video I would like to explain how we can estimate the shear strength of a jointed rock mass. So if we look at some practical examples, a practical application that would be rock slopes and potential rock slides. So you will see that if we have a rock, it will slide down because of the gravity and the friction between this block and slope will prevent this block from sliding down. Another example where we would like to know shear strength of jointed rock mass is shown here when we have a tunnel and jointed, you have a set of discontinuities that will create a block with that can actually slide freely downward due to the gravity. So in this case, again, we would like to know the shear strength between rock blocks. And to do that, we're going to use Barton's criteria. And this is the example that we're going to do, the practical example. So before we do this example, I would like to show you the formula and how we can use it. So this is what we'd like to get in the end. This is the shear strength of a jointed rock mass. How do we know that it's jointed rock mass? You will see that we have a few things. Here is joint roughness coefficient, JRC. I have a video that explains how we can measure JRC for different rock surfaces. Please watch that one. You will see the link in the description of this video. So another thing that we'll need to know is this residual friction angle. So this friction angle, either we assume it. So typically we'd assume it depending on the rock geology, it can vary from 25 to 30 degrees. Sometimes that can be a little bit higher. So the way to obtain this friction angle is we'll just perform a tilt test. And again, I have a video how to do a tilt test. Please watch it. Again, the link will be in the description. So then you will see that this one is normal stress, sigma n, it's here and over there. So we will need to know the normal stress acting at particular depth. And there is a video how to estimate normal stress for rock mass. Please watch that as well. And another component in this equation is JCS. So that one would show the strength of rock surface. So if we look at this rock surface here, for example, so that will be the strength of that rock material at that part of the block, right? So the way we can do it is we can bring a Schmidt hammer and we can use a Schmidt hammer to estimate the strength of that rock surface. I have a video about how to use a Schmidt hammer and how to analyze the data from a Schmidt hammer test. You will find the link in the description. Please watch it. So in this case, we're just given the data. In some cases, we assume that this, what is called joint wall compressive strength, it's approximately equal to unconfined compressive strength of the rock. And well, I have a video about unconfined compressive strength as well. So, and how to analyze the data from this test, please watch it. So everything will be in the description, all the links. So now let's look at the example. So in this case, we would like to estimate the shear strength of jointed granite. And the application is the tunnel. So that's this one, right, tunnel. So we know that depth is 90 meters, so pretty deep. So this is 90 meters down. And what we also know that the density of the rock, it's granite, it's given here, 2.9 grams per cubic centimeters. GRC, I guess when they examine rock blocks, they notice that it was pretty rough, the surface. So GRC was in this range from 16 to 18, which is really pretty high. They did Schmidt-Hammer test and they did some correlation. So, and they obtained this unconfined compressive strength of 85 MPa, which looks reasonably high. But this is granite, so that's probably a nice, a good value. And the residual friction angle of that surface, well, probably they performed tilt test or they made some assumptions. Sometimes we just make assumptions at 31 degrees. So we need to estimate the shear strength of this jointed granite. So, well, basically we know everything. We know the residual friction angle. We know GRC. We know JCS. The only thing we don't know is the normal stress. And by now you should be able to calculate normal stress without any difficulties. So you know that normal stress, it's unit weight times the depth. So in this case, I'm gonna use Z for depth, right? So we're given density, you see, just be careful, we're given density. Just get this blue color. So you know that unit weight, it's density times gravitational acceleration, which is 9.81, those are numbers, right? So you will see that the unit weight will be 2.9 times 9.81, will give us 28.45, so kilonewtons per cubic meters. And next step is to estimate normal stress at depth of 90 meters. So in this case, it will be unit weight 28.45 times 90 meters. So that will give us value, I will convert it to MPa, 2.56 megapascals. So that's the normal stress that we would expect at the depth of 90 meters. And now we just estimate the shear strength of that jointed rock mass. Of course, it will depend on the normal stress. So the greater the normal stress, the greater the shear strength is going to be. So I'm going to write this equation. So shear strength is, where you know that normal stress is 2.56. Times next one is going to be tangent of the angle, residual friction angle 31 degrees plus, okay, so for GRC, we have a range from 16 to 18, which is going to get the average, which is 17. And then we have log with base of 10. And this component is JCS, which is given 85, and divided by the normal stress, where you know that it's 2.56. So when we do calculations, we're gonna get that shear strength is approximately 3.92 MPa. So that's gonna be the answer. So you see, in this case, there is no information about groundwater level. So there is probably no water because it's granite and fresh granite with maybe a few joints. So in this case, there is no any groundwater level there. If there is any information, if we deal with sandstone, which is very porous material, so there may be some groundwater present at different depths. So in this case, we will need to consider the groundwater level when we estimate this normal stress. So we have to deduct the value of water pressure. But in this case, it was pretty dry rock mass, so the answer is 3.92 MPa. So I believe now you have a better idea how to estimate the shear strength of a jointed rock mass using the Barton's criterion. Thanks for watching this video and have a nice day. Bye.